It was a helicopter to lift helicopters. Not only could the base model carry payloads up to 20,000 pounds, but it also held records as the fastest climbing helicopter and the highest cruising helicopter at 36,000 feet. The Sikorsky Aircraft CH-54 Tarhe was undoubtedly ambitious. Used in civil transport, it became incredibly valuable to the U.S. military in the Vietnam War, as it was capable of retrieving downed aircraft and transporting massive weapons such as the Daisy Cutter. A bold proposal even sought to build a behemoth version that could be used to retrieve the first stages of Saturn V launch vehicles and to carry intercontinental ballistic missiles. Development. The CH-54 Tarhe is a twin-engine heavy-lift rotorcraft designed for the U.S. Army by Sikorsky Aircraft. The company was established in 1923 by Russian-American aviator Igor Sikorsky, who's credited by most historians for the invention of the modern helicopter. A civil-use version of the helicopter was also designed, labeled S-64. The project began in 1958, after the Army approached Sikorsky seeking a heavy-lift helicopter for a variety of operations. Partially based on the Mojave helicopter, Sikorsky built the S-60 prototype. The sole example of the helicopter was lost during a test flight in April of 1961, but the project continued. The first turboshaft version of the Skycrane flew on May 9, 1962. Pleased with the results, the United States Army bought 105 helicopters, designated CH-54, and used primarily in the Vietnam War for transport and the retrieval of fallen planes. The helicopter broke the 1971 world altitude record for level flight by cruising at 36,000 feet. It also set records for the fastest climbs to 3, 6, and 9,000 feet. In 1959, an upgrade sought to make the vehicle more efficient for operations, and the new model saw the introduction of turbines. Independent research and development funds allocated to the project totaled over $11 million, excluding engine development costs. Concerns about the high price tag were eventually overcome by the helicopter's unique benefits, as the U.S. Army relied on them frequently. Tarhe. Tarhe, also known as the Crane, was a tribal leader for the Wyandot people, or Huron Nation, in Ohio. He lived from 1742 to 1818 and played a prominent role in the fight against American expansion in Ohio. His war efforts ended with the defeat of the Western Indian Confederacy at the Battle of Fallen Timbers in August of 1794. Still, he's remembered as a significant Native American historical figure. Capabilities. The CH-54 Tarhe was used by the Army to lift and carry heavy objects such as pipes, aircraft, train engines, and other massive things. In theory, it can pick up a small house and take it to a different location miles away. This is accomplished through a hoist that allows pickups and deliveries without having the pilot land. On certain occasions, a small van was attached to the fuselage for use as a command post, repair shop, or even as a mobile Army surgical hospital. When hospital vans were attached to the helicopter, they would be fully equipped with a blood bank and x-ray equipment. It could also lift a pod designed to carry 45 troops and their armament. Without any attachments, the helicopter was designed to carry up to 3 passengers, with 2 men manning the rotorcraft. It weighed 38,000 pounds and could travel 600 nautical miles while cruising with 2 engines, or up to 800 nautical miles while cruising with both engines. Unlike most helicopters, the Sikorsky Skycrane was explicitly designed for lifting heavy loads. Other helicopters will usually deploy their attachment for external payloads below the center of gravity, and therefore risk crashing if the pilot attempts to free the cargo by doing anything that is not pulling vertically. The Skycrane was free of those concerns. The helicopter was powered by twin Pratt & Whitney T-73 P-700 4800 horsepower turbine engines. It featured 2 cockpits, one forward and one below facing aft. The second cockpit allowed the rear-facing pilot to observe the cargo, and therefore coordinate with precision during the hoisting process. The twin-engined lifting rotor system received widespread landing gear so it could straddle large payloads and facilitate pickup. Thanks to its maneuverability, vertical lift, and especially its detachable pods, the Skycrane served as an all-purpose transport helicopter. The pods were chosen depending on the needs of a particular mission, and just as the helicopter, saw multiple upgrades during the military use. A troop and cargo carrier pod could hold up to 60 people. The Skycrane could also carry missiles or missile launchers. Additionally, it could be used for towing considerably sized vehicles. At the start of 1969, the U.S. Army contracted Sikorsky Aircraft to upgrade the Skycrane so that it could carry payloads of 25,000 pounds rather than 20,000. The proposed modification, designated S-64F, saw an increase in overall weight to 47,000 pounds and improved the helicopter's performance in hot, humid weather. It also featured improvements to its speed when gaining altitude and modifications to its dynamic components. Use. The CH-54 Tarhe helicopters, procured by the U.S. Army, were incredibly valuable for lifting operations in South Vietnam. Their extensive use and successful operations made the need for them self-evident. Their ease of maneuverability and speed made it perfect for battlefield recovery. By some estimates, the high number of fallen aircraft retrieved from inaccessible zones by the Skycrane made the investment worth it. Each Skycrane paid for itself by between 4 to 6 times the initial cost of the helicopter. Typically, the Tarhe was sent to recover a downed aircraft when the payload was deemed too heavy for the Boeing Vertol CH-47 Chinook. It also served extensively to offload cargo from ships to the shore upon arrival. In a combat role, the Tarhe could be rigged to carry a 10,000-pound cratering bomb to form a landing zone in the middle of the thick jungle vegetation. The Tarhe served with the 1st Cavalry Division until the end of the Vietnam War. It was gradually replaced by the less capable but flexible Chinook. The Defense Advanced Research Project Agency also tasked the Skycrane with moving heavy armament and equipment over Vietnamese lands that were otherwise impassable. The new assignment allowed ground units to improve and increase the use of air power over conventional counter-guerrilla war techniques. The Tarhe was also valuable for airlifting and combat. During the November of 1965 Battle of Ia Drang, the Tarhe carried multiple howitzers to an advantageous position facing the enemy area in An Lao Valley. Since this was the first time such a thing was done during combat, the crew and unit were unsure about how the helicopter would perform. They reduced the weight of the weapons to 12,600 pounds and relied on the assistance of Chinook helicopters. A 4-gun battery was transported 15 miles towards the target, which took around 2 hours. The success of the mission marked the beginning of artillery transportation with the CH-54. Among the impressive achievements of the Tarhe was the constant lifting of the 155mm howitzer gun into advantageous positions that had been unobtainable. Therefore, ground elements could enter any terrain with medium-range artillery support. In anticipation of the 1966 Operation Masher White Wing, the most extensive search and destroy mission of the war up to that point, the Army required howitzer artillery guns, which the Skycrane airlifted and distributed. Furthermore, the success of the Tarhe helicopter in carrying heavy weapons changed some aspects of the war. It became part of the campaign strategy to select hilltops for artillery posts and to set up camps, as the elevations were easier to defend and provided visibility for soldiers to fire. In the spring of 1967, the 1st Cavalry Division received orders to install a battalion task force in the Duc Pho area in less than 12 hours, and then to increase that task force to brigade size within 36 hours. The area needed a heavy-duty airstrip so the Air Force could send troops and planes. It was decided that a C-7A Caribou strip had to be erected at Landing Zone Montezuma. Of particular importance was the introduction of C-130 aircraft. The Montezuma landing area had enough space for a parallel strip, while the first one underwent improvements to manage the C-130. For the construction work, 29 Skycrane sorties and 15 Chinook sorties had to airlift 31 pieces of heavy engineering equipment with a collective weight of over 200 tons over 2 days. For ease of transportation, many of the items had to be disassembled. The airstrip was constructed within the allotted time frame, thanks to the Skycrane. Super Skycrane. The Super Skycrane was a proposal with unclear levels of consideration to create a more ambitious version of the CH-54. The idea, however, did not come from Sikorsky. Small helicopter company owner Stanley Hiller imagined an upgraded behemoth helicopter that could retrieve the first stages of Saturn V launch vehicles as they drifted back to the ground on a parachute. Unfortunately, his company only bought a selective number of small helicopters. The company was not on the radar of anyone who could offer or consider such a project. Sikorsky Aircraft, on the other hand, had the necessary resources. After connecting with the more prominent company, they at least toyed with Hiller's proposal. 1960s promotional artwork shows the Super Crane lifting missiles for the Air Force. While the depiction does not fully embrace Hiller's vision, it does show a more realistic approach for a bigger CH-54. It's been speculated that Sikorsky Aircraft considered the project as a tie-in to the Air Force's research into mobile ballistic missiles. Few details are publicly available on the projects that considered such a weapon. Still, it is known that the Air Force studied the possibility of mobile intercontinental ballistic missiles in an attempt to keep them in constant movement, and therefore safer from the Soviet Union. Still, these studies were mostly carried out at the same time that the Air Force dug gopher holes in the Midwest to bury the Minuteman missiles. Since building the tunnels took billions of dollars and was a readily available option, they chose not to pursue mobile ICBMs. Had the mobile ICBM project come to fruition, the missiles would have been carried around New England in railroad cars and possibly a Super Skycrane. But without missiles for giant helicopters to carry, Hiller's dream of Super Skycranes died. Commercial end. Due to budget cuts, the heavy lift helicopter program under which the CH-54 Tarhe updates were planned was canceled. The Army retired the Tarhe Skycranes in the 1970s. It replaced them with the Boeing CH-47 Chinook that had been gradually supplementing aviation units. The sky cranes continued to serve the Army National Guard until the late 1980s when the rotorcraft were removed entirely from the military. The previously military-use helicopters were transferred to civil service, with particular use in commerce. They continued to perform heavy lift operations in this capacity, especially for the lumber industry. The military shifted to using heavy lift aircraft with cabin room for both cargo and troops. The current largest fleet of sky cranes is operated by Ericsson Aircrane in Central Point, Oregon. Some of these helicopters have been adapted with water or gel-dropping equipment for firefighting duties around the world. Since 1992, Ericsson Aircrane has been the sole manufacturer of the rotorcraft.